Welcome to the third in a series of tutorials designed to enable you to use the Queensland Globe with confidence. In this tutorial, we will look at ways to view and query information associated with many of the data layers in the Queensland Globe. We will also talk about the concept of places as a way to store locations and customize your map. The learning outcomes from this tutorial are an understanding of how to view and query specific information, ability to use places to store locations and customize the map. The simplest way to view information about a data layer is through the map legend. When you add, remove, or alter visibility of layers, the legend content will update automatically. If you have added your own data or services, these data layers will be displayed at the top of the legend. You can also view information by the Identify tool. With this tool, you can click on the map and a list of all the data layers visible at that location will display. There are a number of selection shapes you can use to refine your search. Choose the option that is most suitable for your query. Drill down further by clicking through the results to reveal all the information or attributes associated with that feature. Toggle through the attributes panel by selecting the back or forward arrows. As you toggle, the main map window will highlight and zoom to your selected object. Some layers have links to related features. By clicking on a related feature link, more information is revealed. Navigate to the initial search results using the back arrow. The Queensland Globe allows you to query data layers by specific criteria. Once you have added your target data layer, within the Layers panel, click the drop-down arrow to expand and reveal more options. From here, you can choose to query layer attributes. Populate your query criteria and select Query Layer to run your search. You can constrain this search to the current extent, otherwise it will query the entire data set. The search results will display the count of features that meet your criteria. You can then download these features in a number of formats, depending on your preference. Alternatively, as you drill down to the individual features, you can choose to add results to places. This will enable you to save your query results for future use. As you select each individual feature, the map window will automatically zoom to the feature extent. Places will hold not only your search or query results, you can use places to store new map objects that you create. To create new map objects, use the Queensland Globe drawing tools, which are accessed via the toolbar. There are many drawing shapes to choose from, depending on the type of map object you want to create. In each case, you can change the symbology of your map object before drawing. When drawing circles and rectangles, click and drag out to the desired size, then release to finish. Use the tick box option to choose between a circle and an ellipse. Lines and polygon objects are started by clicking on the map and finished by double clicking. The help section has more detail on how to draw and edit places, including keyboard shortcuts and map controls. If you have an exact coordinate that you wish to create, use the coordinate plot tool. You will have different coordinate system options to choose from. Once you have created your map object, it will automatically appear in places. As per the Layers panel, you can alter the visibility. By default, it will be labeled as My Place and then numbered. You can customize your new map object in a number of ways, like renaming or changing the symbology. If you would like to further identify your newly created map object, you can choose to add a label to the map. Clicking this option will reveal further options to customize this label, and your map will now display your map object and a label. Edit Places will allow you to make changes to your new map object. For example, if you wanted to move, resize, or add and remove vertices. Alternatively, you can remove places altogether, so they are removed from your Queensland Globe session. There is also an option to query layers using your place object. This will perform a spatial query, returning all features from open map layers that intersect this. The search results are presented in a similar manner to the query layer attribute function we looked at earlier. Results can be bulk added to places, or alternatively, you can select individual features. While place objects are temporary, they can be saved for future use through saving the map. More information about saving maps is available in an upcoming Queensland Globe tutorial. We hope you have enjoyed this tutorial on the Queensland Globe. If you need further assistance, please have a look at the other tutorials in this series, check the in-depth guide on our help page, or email opendata.com.